Welcome to Bloodbath and Beyond. Today we review The Door. Some doors are not meant to be opened.
Brought to us by Black Fawn Distribution, written and directed by Patrick McBrearty, The Door, starring Alys Crocker and Sam Kantor, is about a man who gets a job, and that job is to watch a door. He can't let anything out, and he can't let anything in. Unfortunately, he lets one of his friends slip by him, and they go behind the door. Now he must venture out and discover what is actually behind the door.
Because this is a brand new film, this is going to be spoiler free. We're not going to tell you any of the kills that happen or give away any major plot points.
So what do we like about this?
I greatly enjoyed the pacing of this film. I found the way they built the atmosphere up through the use of music and their editing styles, it really kept you engaged, building you towards what could be a jump scare, and you don't know when it's going to happen. And that's really good for a jump scare movie.
Throughout the entire film, you're just honestly on the edge of your seat, and it was enjoyable, even for me, someone who doesn't like jump scares.
I really enjoyed that the story kept the audience mimicking what the feelings of the main characters were. Like, we were learning things at the same time they were learning things. So the scares were actually that much more intense because we didn't know what to be afraid of or what was going to happen. I also enjoyed that we didn't know what was behind the door. We didn't know if death was waiting behind the door or if there was some weird government secrets because the dudes dressed in suits. It kind of kept us guessing, like, oh, what's over there? Or are they actually going to go behind the door? We didn't really know.
The shots that they used and the techniques they used a lot of long takes that were similar to The Strangers. And they're keeping shots on in the background out of focus longer than what they should be, and it's drawing your attention to there could be something behind that person, but we don't know exactly what.
To go along with that, even like the characters mimicked that. Like, they're like, I think there's something down there. Like, maybe it's moving? Like, I don't know.
That brings me to the acting. I thought all of the acting was really well done, especially for a mainly first-time cast. And they were able to act pretty naturally when they heard something and trying to convince their friends that, like, something might be happening somewhere else, and maybe some of the friends aren't really playing along because they think they're full of shit. It was pretty cool. One of the best parts about this film, I think, was the set and how they lit the set. It's just like a huge big factory, and it just looked really cool, and especially with limited light, they used it very well. In certain rooms, you might have like one light hanging from the ceiling, or one person's got a flashlight, or maybe just a light on their phone, and it's lighting just enough for you to be able to see the main character and some of the surroundings, but not everything, which again keeps you guessing.
When they go into a lot of open space rooms, we see like a chair and a lamp, and we see just like a bunch of lamps, and that's all that's lit. It is like the hospital in Silent Hill.
So what didn't we like?
There was a lot of moments in this film where they were playing off of the confusion and trying to confuse the cast members or the characters in the film, and it ended up confusing the audience, and you didn't know what was real and what wasn't real, and it wasn't really well established by the end of the film, which was a little disappointing.
I actually thought this movie was missing some substance. I was really nervous and like scared along with the characters, which was cool, but I feel like that's all it was, and I kind of wish there was a little bit more to the story. It felt like a short to me. It didn't feel like a full movie.
Yeah, I agree. It seemed like there was not much closure to what was happening throughout the film. Weird stuff happens behind the door, and you just never really ever get a solid explanation as to what it is. My main dislike plays off of Collins' main like, which was the story follows the characters and you find out things as they find it out. Well, the problem with that is when we experience something through one character, if they run into another person, they have to tell them everything that happened in the previous scene. And this happened every time that a character ran into another, because they say, oh, I found this in this room, or I saw somebody over here. Well, yeah, we experienced that with this group of people. And so when they go and tell everybody, we're hearing the same stuff that we already saw, which basically led to a lot of useless conversation and useless dialogue scenes between a lot of the characters.
Now it's time for our final thoughts and ratings. I really liked The Door. It gave me a Twilight Zone feel. A nice, like, simple storyline, huge mystery, not knowing anything about it. I thought it was pretty cool. I'm not usually a fan of jump scare movies, but I thought this one did it justice. It was that extra bit of mystery that made it worth it to try to figure out what's next, what's gonna keep going. That's why I think I'd actually want people to come out and actually watch this movie. So with all that said, I'm gonna give this 3.5 mysterious boxes out of 5.
This was a pretty decent indie horror film. It's nice to see something with this much mystery come out these days. It was shot well, it was acted well, and I thought the lighting and the sound design was spot on. So I'm gonna give this 3 mysterious doors out of 5.
I absolutely love me a good jump scare movie. The cinematography was great, the pacing really set the mood, and it was just so tense because you didn't know what was gonna happen. And I really enjoyed that. And I think you guys are gonna enjoy that too. Though some moments could have been explained more throughout this film, I'm not gonna take that away from it because it really was a good film. So that being said, I'm going to give it 3.5 mysterious phones out of 5.
As always, thanks for watching. Like this video, comment below with a film that you think is actually scary, but maybe doesn't have too many jump scares. To stay up to date with everything Bloodbath and Beyond, make sure you subscribe.